After a long day of enjoying himself, Inspector Clouseau is ready to get it on. He's already in there, saying my lovely little darling to Maria Gambrelli, his future baby mama. And, you know, he's in there, he's about to get it all on, but being the bumbling detective that Inspector Clouseau always was, you know it's going to take a little while. He finally gets it in, and then that's when the door starts to open, and then that's when we see Cato. Now, after all the times that Inspector Clouseau told Cato to attack him when necessary, I doubt this is the time he wanted. So, Cato proceeds to attack. Maria Gambrelli has no idea what's going on. And, you know, Inspector Clouseau is trying to get Cato out of there. He's getting hit with the pillow. Cato getting beat up like he always does. And Maria Gambrelli's about to put him out of his misery. Bop. She knocked him out. She didn't kill him. She starts to scream Jacques, which is his name, Jacques Clouseau. She thought she killed him. He says it's only Cato, and that's all it is. Now, although this whole scene that I played has a bit of a comedy effect to it, I want to start teaching y'all a little something about the kind of people you hang out with and the kind of people you allow. You see, you know deep down inside if you're an introverted person. You're basically somebody that doesn't like a lot of people around you. You're shy. You get shy quickly. You're afraid of being the butt of jokes and all of that kind of stuff. All right? Something somebody might have had to deal with all their life. So you find that one friend that you think would be okay because they're more or less, and so in a lot of ways, in the same boat as you are. You find that one friend. Only the problem with that particular friend is that there's something about them that's just quite embarrassing in a lot of ways. And that's because a group of introverted people are embarrassing. Okay? If you ever notice, if you ever hang out with somebody that's an introvert like yourself, there's either something of a physical appearance that would make you not want to walk down the street with them. There could be something as far as their handicap. They could be slower than most people usually are. There could be something with behavioral issues. There's usually always going to be something. So, introverts are usually people that are going to embarrass you. They're the types that have no problem doing dumb things in public that could embarrass someone. So these are the things to pay attention to. And now one of the things you got to do is check immediately. You got to talk to them like, look, you need to kind of calm down a little bit. There is a such thing as, what is the word I'm looking for right now? I cannot believe it's not hitting me right now. What's the word I'm looking for? Moderation. There we go. There's a such thing as moderation. Playing around is good. Playing around all the time is not. Okay? You can't make it one note. And that's another bad thing about a lot of introverted cats. One of the reasons why a lot of introverted cats play around a lot and do things out of aggression to you and all of that is mainly because their social skills suck. These are things you have to check. So we have to help an introverted person. You have to check them on how they talk and all of that and have your side talks with them. Here goes number three on, I don't know if I even numbered these, but just go with me. Here goes another one on introverted people. When introverted people see a person that's popular, a person that's sort of normal and all of that, and when they get a little bit of attention from somebody like that, they then start to show off. Who are they going to show off and start turning into a victim? The one friend they got. That's going to end up being the victim in order for them to be down. Dude, you coming to my house later and you acting like that towards me? So you got to do that. And in order to combat the disrespect, you gotta let them know, look, I don't want to see you for a little while. You're doing a little too much. You're doing too much double crossing. A lot of the double crossing comes because a lot of people want to be down and they just don't have the tools to make it there. The type of people who's behind that they always kiss, they don't end up hanging out with them later on when, let's say if it's when proximity is over. Proximity meaning if you're in a place of work, if you're in school, if you're in some place where y'all gotta meet, or you know, shelter. I had to do time in the shelter. Any place that requires proximity, those guys don't end up hanging out after a while. Now, you're the one that's giving this person your time and attention. You're hanging out with them. You're doing all that, and they're betraying you for it. You got to stand on squares. You got to look at the behavior. Pay attention to the actions, and it would be impossible to see who's bad or who's not. Anyway, everybody, that's how it is. Check your people around you, and please learn from this.